Stephen Johnson Stocks. It's wonderful to be back. I wish it was with better news, but I was up pretty much over $1,000 and I took big size on PTI and put his red on the month, went from up a grand to down a grand, and I said to myself, like, that is it. I'm not shorting pre-market. I'm not shorting gappers anymore. I'm done with it. I had 8 green months now. I've had 5 straight red ones. Even if it balanced out, I need a strategy with more sustainability. So it's almost goodbye to the gapping crap. There I say it. And I was going to do this whole fucking video where I was like, all the good times, all the times when I was making money, I was going to put an emotional soundtrack. And then I was just like, you know what it is? I'm working tons at work. I'm working tons of freelance stuff. I'm doing all these podcasts and videos. I'm learning new strategies trading. I just kind of do it. Because basically I'm being treated like a fucking... I'm not being treated like when I chose this, but I'm like a fucking coal miner. I'm just shoveling coal like a fucking 5-year-old from Newcastle with no education. But I have got an education. I have. So let's just go straight into the trades. Live the dream and I'll catch you in a bit.
So it's a tough one to say goodbye to the gap and crap strategy because I've had some epic times with it. I mean, I remember back in April when biotechs were just gapping and you just have 200-day. That was a stupid short on tops, I remember. 500-day, cut your loss. 300-day, bad day there, but 500, 300, 1,000. But the market's just not the same and biotechs aren't gapping and it's kind of a strategy which isn't coming around anymore. And when it does, for the likes of this month, I mean, we had the likes of OGEN was a nice short, but I mean, PTI was just, I mean, this is red, 2,600 loss. I mean, even if I'd cut it when I should have, it would have been about 800 and I would have been kind of flat on the month. So I'd be flat on a month on a strategy that never comes around. And I'm like, and there's an argument of like, just cut the higher day breaks, but I mean, for me, I just can't cut them. And it ends up in disaster in these months. And yeah, you'll have some good months. But on the whole, I mean, I had no workable strategy. Then gapping crap started coming around and I was tracking them. And I saw a gap in the market where stocks were gapping and failing and took some money. And then the strategy was off and on for a few months. And then it's just not worked at all for the last 6 months and it's been quiet. So I need to find a new feasible strategy. It's really disappointing and kind of upsetting that I'm almost back to square one, but I'm absolutely not back to square one because me read on daily, intraday, price action, news, catalyst, everything is, I would say it's pretty strong, it's pretty good. Just the one fault that I've continuously had is trying this strategy in a market that doesn't cater as much to it anymore, and then when it does come around and it's been volatile, I've not been able to cut the higher days continuously. And for 5 months, I've proven, I mean, for about some months, I just got away with not cutting losses. But I mean, I've proven time and time over, I just cannot cut higher day on first green day on a gapper. I just can't. So I need to look at a new strategy that's safer. So I've covered them for years, but welcome to sadly what might be the last gapping crap analysis. I mean, the only difference between OGEN I made about $420 on, PTI I lost 2,600. The only difference is the volume. And with OGEN, I mean, OGEN is, it's got a ton of people underwater. It's like a 20 mil float. But you can guarantee that most of its volume was traded on this day on the 2nd of October. And a lot of people will probably look how it gaps. You see how it gaps here and it gaps here. A lot of chasers, a lot of longs are kind of trying to ride this up, hoping it goes from the threes to the fours because it looks so strong. But as we know, stocks that have 1, 2, 3 green days generally fail on the fourth. So a lot of people are probably trapped in the third. It's got this down kind of trend here. And the minute it gaps up, the theory is as long as it doesn't trade too much volume, there'll still be people here getting up on the gap up. And that's the theory. Generally, how we saw it was the stock gapped on some weak press release and it just comes straight back down. I was shorting in the 150s and I was covering in the 130s. Simple as that. I traded 13 million on the day. Now, difference with PTI is I've just come off the back of the Orjan win. It's feeling confident. And I was looking at this chart thinking, we just go back, say, 1 year before this had ever happened. I'm thinking, I mean, this gaps and goes as well. But it generally, I mean, if you look at Orjan was a multi-day runner. This kind of has one day and then it kind of comes down. But it does have a history of gapping and going, which is exactly the setup that I don't want. But I'm thinking, again, I mean, look, you've got 32 million up here. And I thought, the problem was, I thought this was a 20 million float. It turns out it was a 9 million float. So that's another error that I made. But it's still, I can't cut the higher days for shit anyway. I thought, 30 million people, it's gap down here. So when I'm seeing it in the threes, I'm thinking it's got resistance in the fours. And unless it trades 30 million, it's never going to run up to the past the fours or fives. And the problem was it traded 80, 90, 96 million. And that's where I got fucked. There's too much volume. So for me, I was shorting around this 358 level. When it broke the high of day here, I hung on just for a second in the hope that it may just kind of break out and fail. And then when it ripped up here, I was out in the 410s. So I was short from like the 350s. I was out in the 410s. I was actually out 408. And that was leaving it late. Say a 360 average, out 410. I mean, I still lost 50 cents, which is pretty wide risk. But when you look at the fact that it went to the 11s, I mean, that would have blew up me count three times over. So ultimately a good cover, but I took a bit too much size. I didn't cut it tight enough and I underestimated the volume. It had traded a couple of million here and about, it was trading like 3 or 4 million around here. So I knew I was in for some danger, but it's hard. The problem is, and the way I'm going wrong is, it's hard to predict. I mean, I can say if it trades a mil pre-market, I'll probably trade 10 million on the day off. If it trades 3 million pre-market, it's probably going to trade 20. And this traded like 10 million pre-market, which means it'll probably trade about 80 or 90. And if it trades 500,000, it'll probably trade 4 million on the flow. It's going to trade 10 or 11 million. It's going to trade around 10 or 11 times more than it trades pre-market on average. But you don't know when a big investor is going to come in. You don't know when rapid volume is going to come in, or it cracks and it doesn't crack, and then loads of buyers come in and loads of short covers, and that increases the volume. So you're kind of playing a blind hand, and then you're playing a blind hand, so you don't know what's going to happen, so you don't want to cut the high of the day. I need a strategy where I can see what's happened at the open, where the hands, where the stock has played its hand, and I can see exactly where the support or resistance levels are to risk off daily levels rather than risking off blind levels.
And to conclude, basically just what I want to say is my plan is to really start researching and looking at different strategies that are not short in pre-market. Now, that leaves an open door. I don't know what I'm going to find, but I'm going to explore a lot of different things. And I'll update you on it. And I mean, do I feel like a bit of a failure that I'm kind of starting on the whiteboard from scratch after 2 years? I mean, yeah, I feel like a bit of a failure. And do you know what else makes us feel like a bit of a failure? That I've been chasing a girl for 2 months. And I still haven't got her, and half the time she doesn't reply to me text messages. That makes us feel like a failure. It makes us feel like, fuck that. So maybe I'm good with trading. I'm going to learn new strategies. I'm going to stop what doesn't work. The girl's fit. She's very fit, and she's cool, and she likes the same shit as me. Should I continue chasing her? Can you just comment yes or no? And I'll leave it at that. And fuck loving her. I love you guys. I'll tell you what, the numbers are dwindling. I'm like, Facebook, Instagram's taking over. It's like, YouTube's dying for me, almost. Steady Trade's taking over. But you know what it is? I'm a digital motherfucker, so I'll be on Steady Trade. Then when Steady Trade dies, I'll be on something else because I stay on top of the trends. But I don't stay on top of that girl. But I fucking love you guys. Even the ones left. I love you guys who stuck with us, and this song is dedicated to you. It's not dedicated to the girl because she's fucking, she's not there. She doesn't even text us back, so shoot back!
Amelia! I see you waiting, your hands up, your body shaking. It's hard luck, I know you're faking, I know you lie. I've seen you lying, performing.